Hello and welcome to this MAMP, the free edition screencast. Today I'm going to be talking about the Open WebStart page. I'm going to be using Mac OS X Yosemite and MAMP 3.072. Okay, so on your interface here, your MAMP interface, you have this Open WebStart page. You can click on it once you have your servers up and running. So if you click on Open WebStart, you will be taken to your default browser and you will be at the MAMP, your WebStart page. On the WebStart page, there's a few links up here. I'm gonna go over them right now. The PHP info page, if you click on this, it's gonna give you information about your current installed version of PHP that you are using. Under tools, you can go to your PHP My Admin. This is a database administrator. It's going to tell you, well, it's a database administration, so you can administer your databases with this or look at them and see what's in there. If you have a content management system, you can check out and see what kind of data is being written to the database. And we have a couple. We have PHP My Admin and PHP Lite Admin under this menu. Some frequently asked questions. The MAMP website. If you want to go to the MAMP website, you can go there. Okay, and we also have a couple of links I want to explain now. My website and my favorite link. First, my website. When you click on my website, it's going to go to your default document route. So my website right now, I just clicked on it and it says hello world. I made a hello world PHP script in my HT docs, my default applications HT docs, default applications MAMP HT docs directory. I'll go and show you what I mean here. So if I go into my MAMP and I look at my preferences, my document root is set to applications MAMP HT docs, and that is the website that is in this directory. Now I can change that. I always recommend not using the default document root and changing it to somewhere outside of the applications MAMP folder. We keep this as the default, even though I'm here recommending to change it because there are many, many blogs out there and websites that have instructions with this applications MAMP HT docs directory, and we don't want to change that. So, I'm going to go ahead and change my document root to something else. I have a host directory, which is inside of my documents directory, and, so it's going to be documents host now. And inside this directory, I do have several hosts. So when I go back to my, and my servers will automatically start. So when I go to my website page again, this is a directory with a bunch of directories in it. And if I click on one of these links now, I have another host, another hello world, and I have several other hosts here. So that way my hosts are outside of the applications MAMP folder, and when I do update, I don't have to worry about moving my hosts around. My hosts are safe inside my documents folder, documents host, and that's a good way to keep your old websites organized. Okay, so back to the bar here, tab. We also have my favorite link, and my favorite link is just another link that you can use to for easy access. A few people complained earlier. We had PHP My Admin here on the top menu here, and now you have to click through a menu to get to it. Well, I set up my favorite link to go directly to my PHP My Admin site, and I'll show you how I did that. In my preferences, I have an alias set up to on my favorite link to slash phpMyAdmin, which is an alias. inside your php.ini file. And so when I click on my my favorite link, I get sent straight to my phpMyAdmin. Now you can change this to anything you want. You can say, for instance, say you, I don't know, want to, we'll just say apple.com here. You always have a quick link. Of course, your servers will start and stop and start again. You have a quick link to Apple in case you want a new Mac or something for your, oh, that didn't update. Let's see what happened here. Ah, yes, this is a, I have to refresh here, that's why. And my favorite link should take me now to apple.com. And I can go buy a new Mac or whatever. So that's a few, that covers the top tab here on the web start page. Down below, we have some announcements and stuff like that. And here on the left, we have more, I guess these are links again to your PHP info and phpMyAdmin, and some good examples on how to connect to your database using PHP, Python, or Perl. So some good quick starts on how to do that. One last thing about the web start page is maybe a little confusion with the where this stuff actually is. If you look at your, if you look in the actual URL bar, it says localhost :8888/mamp in language equals English. Some people may be confused about where this stuff is. Earlier I mentioned a in the preferences and with the my favorite link option /phpMyAdmin, I said this setting is in your php.ini file. That's actually wrong. It's in your httpd.conf file, and I'll show you what I mean right now. So these are just aliases /mamp and /phpMyAdmin. These aliases are in your httpd.conf file, the one that runs your Apache server for MAMP. The free edition is here, applications MAMP conf apache httpd.conf. Inside of here, you will have some aliases, and the alias phpMyAdmin will send you to applications MAMP bin phpMyAdmin directory, which of course, when you then click on it, it's going to bring up your phpMyAdmin website web page. Slash MAMP is going to take you to, if you slash MAMP here in the website, is going to take you to this directory, applications MAMP bin MAMP index.php. So that's where all that stuff is. And that's going to conclude this screencast for the web start button and advanced features.